finally tonight, remembering some of the victims of the attacks in Kenya. The assault claimed a number of people known far and wide, and also some of the country's elite. They included Kenyan President Uhuru Kenyatta's nephew, also a popular radio and television journalist in Kenya, a Clinton Foundation staffer who was 8.5 months pregnant, and her fiancé, an architect, were killed as well. And there was renowned Ghanaian poet Kofi Awoonor, whose body was returned home today. Jeffrey Brown gets a personal recollection.
Kofi Awoonor was a poet and novelist, author of numerous volumes, influenced by both his native traditions and Western literature. He was a scholar, teaching in Ghana and the U.S., and a politically engaged statesman, serving as his country's ambassador to the U.N. and serving time in prison for his political beliefs. He was in Nairobi to attend a literary festival. With him and with us now was his nephew and fellow poet, Kwame Dawes, professor at the University of Nebraska and editor of the journal Prairie Schooner. And Kwame, welcome back to our program. And first, let me offer our condolences for the death of your uncle.
It's good to be back, Jeff, and thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Tell us who he was and why he was such an important figure in Ghana and throughout Africa.
Kofi Awoonor belonged to that generation of African poets and African writers that emerged in the late 50s and early 60s who saw a vista of possibility in independence and in a new vision of Africa, Pan-Africanist view of Africa. And his first book of poems came out in 1964. He was about 26 years old at the time. And he would continue to write poetry and write novels. And he had this wonderful sort of role as a great statesman, a fantastic professor and teacher. People in Ghana know him as Prof. And became an international figure as an ambassador and a diplomat. So there's a great loss in Ghana because this is a major figure.
And what did he write about? How did he combine his interest in literature and in the politics that you're talking about?
He came of a generation, and this is the generation that connected him with my father. He was a best friend of my father for many years, and he regarded my father, Neville Dawes, as a kind of mentor. But I remember once talking about my father, and Awoonor fell into that category of men who were artists and writers, but who felt themselves deeply engaged in the political realities of the world. These were left-wing individuals. They called themselves old campaigners. And they believe that literature should speak to the experience of people, should be involved in the process of liberation. And yet, at the same time, they believed in the highest quality of literary expression that engaged both the African traditions, the voices of Africa, the languages of Africa, and yet, and what essentially was a modernist sensibility. And I don't think there's any poet that managed to do that as effectively as Kofi Awoonor. He would be in the category of somebody like Christopher Akibo or Dennis Brutus from South Africa. This is the caliber of writer we're talking about.
Tell us a little bit about the man that you knew, your own personal recollections.
You know, I grew up with him as Uncle Kofi. He was my, you know, father's very good friend. And he was the uncle that we liked to come to the house. There's tremendous laughter, a great deal of energy. But we also knew that he was seriously committed to the struggle. He faced tremendous obstacles. He spent time in jail for his beliefs and for his work. He lived in exile and spent time with us in Jamaica for that work. But we also grew up with him as a cousin to my mother, somebody he loved dearly and so on. But a great, fun, but brilliant man. And later on in life, he became somebody who encouraged my writing and encouraged me as an artist in ways that I just can't explain. So to lose him is a tremendous loss. But I had a chance to see him while I was in Nairobi and to enjoy our fellowship with each other. So that was one good thing.
Well, in fact, you were there and he was there for the literary festival. And I gather he's remained hard at work. You told me earlier you're putting together a new volume of his selected poems.
Yeah, the African Poetry Book Series, which I started, which is committed to publishing African writers, African poets primarily, we asked him if he'd be willing to be our first of a series of new and selected books by major African poets, and he agreed right away. And so in early 2014, we'll be publishing a book called Promises of Hope, new and selected works, which is edited with a selection done by Kofi Awoonor, another great Ghanaian poet. And that book will be out. And in fact, it was the book that took us to Nairobi to be at the Story Moja Hay Festival to celebrate the work and to really start to get interest in African poetry. And you know, that was the celebration. But at the same time, the incredible tragedy that took place just makes it bittersweet.
And Kwame, we're going to end with you reading from part of one of his more recent poems, I think, right? It's called To Feed Our People.
Yes, it's a very new poem. Do not dress me yet. Lift me not unto the mound before the mourners. I have still to meet the morning dew. A poem to write, a field to hoe, a lover to touch, and some consoling to do before you lay me out.
All right, the poetry and life of Kofi Awoonor, as told to us by Kwame Dawes. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Jeff.